Now we are going to study about the speciation. Speciation. Speciation means formation of one or more species from the pre-existing species is called as speciation. Formation of one or more new species from the pre-existing species by evolutionary means or by evolutionary course, that is called as speciation. So here we have talked in the definition that दो एक या एक से ज्यादा नई स्पीशीज का बनना फ्रॉम द प्री एग्जिस्टिंग स्पीशीज फ्रॉम द और वी कैन से दैट फ्रॉम द सेम स्पीशीज. तो सेम स्पीशीज से कैसे दूसरे स्पीशीज बन सकती है, हमें तो ये पढ़ाया गया है या हमें तो ये बताया गया है कि द इंडिविजुअल्स ऑफ द सेम स्पीशीज यूज टू लिव एट वन प्लेस. एक ही स्पीशीज के जितने भी इंडिविजुअल्स हैं वो एक ही प्लेस पर रहते हैं एंड दे यूज टू रिप्रोडक्टिव और दे यूज टू डू मेटिंग बिटवीन देमसेल्व्स. तो जब वो एक दूसरे के साथ में ही मेटिंग करते हैं एंड दे यूज टू लिव एट द सेम प्लेस, तो हाउ द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ हाउ द न्यू स्पीशीज विल बी फॉर्म्ड बाय द सेम स्पीशीज. देर आर सर्टेन फैक्टर्स विच आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ new species. Here we will discuss about that factors only. So the speciation can be done by two means. The first one is gradual speciation and the second one is instant speciation. The first one, we will study now the first one, that is gradual speciation. So gradual speciation is done when or by the reproductive isolation, or we can say that this gradual speciation forms the species. It is a time taking process. It forms or by the process of gradual speciation the new species will be formed after many years. It will take many generations also, or it can take hundreds of years also for the formation of this gradual for the formation of the new species by the gradual speciation. So it is the slow process and it can take few generations also for the formation of new species. This gradual speciation also takes place by two means. One is allopatric speciation and one is sympatric speciation. So what is allopatric speciation? The speciation occurs by the geographical barriers. What we have studied here, that the two or more species or the one or more species are formed by the pre-existing species by some evolutionary means. So what was that evolutionary means? Here allopatric speciation. What happens in the allopatric speciation? The new species is formed due to the we can say that geographical barriers. what kind of geographical barriers? These geographical barriers can be anything like mountains or rivers or oceans. We can understand it by taking the example of Darwin finches. Here the speciation takes place by geographical isolation. Speciation takes place by the geographical isolation, and here we are going to take the example of Darwin finches. This example of Darwin finches we have also studied under the heading biogeographical evidences in the evolution, the evidences of evolution. So, here in the allopatric speciation, we are studying the Darwin finches. What we have studied in that, Darwin has studied this or observed this Darwin finches on Galapagos Island. Studied this on Galapagos Island, and this Galapagos Island is the bunch of 22 small islands, and it is said that this Darwin finches have been arrived from or have been evolved from one single grain eating bird. Suppose that this is the place or this is the mainland where one bird was living, and this bird is the grain eating bird. So, from this mainland, this bird migrated to different places. These are different islands where this bird migrated, and this is one whole area which consists of these all these islands. So, this was the bird on one mainland which was a grain eating bird at that situation in that kind of environment. So, when there were proper food or there were no proper environmental conditions for this bird for living or to lead its life. So, this bird started migrating towards many different islands. There are in the one species we can say that many of the organisms are present. So, few birds migrated to this island, few to this, like this they were distributed to many of the islands. So, it is not necessary that the conditions which were providing here for this bird to live, the same conditions will be provided in this islands also. They were having some different kind of conditions also, we can say. Suppose here they were having the food or the feeding habit of the grains. So, it is not necessary that in all these islands also they were having the feeding habit of with the feeding habit of grains only. They have to eat some other things also, some seeds, or they used to eat some worms or some fishes. Like this, they were getting some different kind of food according to the environmental situation of the all these islands. So, when Darwin observed that the same bird or the bird which is belonging to the same species is having the different, had become the different species, and he observed that this bird is having they are being differentiated only by two things. They were different in the size and they were different in the shape of the beaks, and he observed 20 such varieties of these birds which are being formed from the same species or which have been evolved from the same grain eating species. He found the 20 such varieties which were though they were belonging to the same species, but they were different in their sizes and they were different in their beak shapes. So due to the different environmental conditions or due to the different islands, they were separated by the geographical barriers. So due to the presence of geographical barriers between them, they were having the different environmental conditions. So this represents the allopatric speciation, that species, new species is formed by the geographical isolation. Here one bird was living at one island, and due to some change in the conditions, this migrated to different islands, and due to the geographical barriers between these islands, they grown according to the conditions there or according to the feeding habits there. So therefore they change their shape of the beak as well as the size. Due to this, from one great grain eating bird, the 20 different varieties of birds or the 20 different species were formed. This kind of speciation is called as allopatric speciation, and we cannot say that these 20 species have been formed in the next 20 days. It has taken up to 50 or 60, or we can say that many years. It can also take up to the 100 years for the formation of one species. So the formation of this 20 species has also taken many years longer time. This was the allopatric speciation under the head of gradual speciation. The next one is sympatric speciation. Sympatric speciation means, here we have talked about the speciation takes place by geographical isolation. It is just opposite to that of allopatric speciation. Speciation takes place without the geographical isolation. Speciation takes place without geographical isolation. यहां पर कोई geographical isolation नहीं होता है, कोई geographical hindrance नहीं होता है. Both the species or the that species are living at the same place, in the same habitat, in the same place or on the same island. They were having the same type of habits also. Then also they developed into the different type of species. Here we will take the example of pig frog and gopher frog. This pig frog and gopher frog, they are same species. Technically or originally, when we talk that this pig frog and gopher frog, they both are the same species, but due to the change in their habitat, or we can say that in their ecological niche, due to the change in their habitat or in the ecological niche, they developed in different species. यहां पर तो reproductive यहां पर तो geographical isolation था, कुछ difference था. They were having some kind of differences. They what differences? In difference in the environmental situation or difference in the feeding habit or habitat or anything else. So they were having some kind of difference between the same species. Therefore a new species was formed. But here there is no difference. They are living at the same continent or on the same island. Though they were living at the same continent, they developed into the two different species because they had their different ecological niche. They having their different habitats. Therefore, the same species developed into the two different kind of species. This was about the sympatric speciation. The next one in the category of speciation is instant speciation. First, we have talked about the gradual speciation. There are two means of gradual speciation, allopatric and sympatric. Now, we will discuss about the instant speciation. Instant speciation. It is also called as sudden speciation or abrupt speciation. Instant speciation, sudden speciation or abrupt speciation. This instant speciation also takes place by two means. The first one is mutation and the second one is hybridization. We have studied earlier this mutation, that we are having two types of mutation, chromosomal mutation and gene mutation. The chromosomal mutation is having again two types, morphological mutations and the numeric mutations. In the morphological mutations, we are having the four categories of mutation, that is deletion, inversion, translocation and duplication. And in the numeric mutations, we are having aneuploidy and polyploidy. And when we are talking about the gene mutation, the first one is point mutation. Point mutation means the mutation due to the exchange of or due to the change in the nucleotide, or in the change in the one nucleotide, by the insertion of one nucleotide or by the deletion of one nucleotide, that is called as point mutation, or we can say that the frame shift mutation. So, any of the change that happens, or any of the speciation, if any of the mutation happen and any new species is formed by this mutation, that is called as instant speciation. When we were talking about that mutation theory, in which that Hugo de Vries, he was working on his plant Oinothera lamarckiana, he said that he observed his main concentration was on the fact that mutation occurs only due to the change in the chromosomal number. And he got the species which were having different chromosomal number. Originally, Oinothera lamarckiana was having 14 chromosomes. And after that, what he got the next species, it was having the chromosome number 18, 20, 22, 24, like this. So, they were having the change in their chromosomal number. And he named that change in the chromosomal number species as Oinothera gigas. So, like this, due to the mutation, Oinothera lamarckiana was the one species, and mutation hone ke karan ek dusri species develop ho gai, which was having the difference in their chromosomal number, that was Oinothera gigas, that was introduced by Hugo de Vries. Like this, agar mutation hoga aur mutation ke karan koi bhi species agar banti hai, then that is called as instant type of speciation or sudden or abrupt speciation. Now, the second type of speciation, that is hybridization, that we are going to discuss. Hybridization. What is hybridization? When the organisms of the two different species, they fuse with each other or they mate with each other. The process of the mating of the organisms of two different species is called as hybridization, and the result of the mating of that species is called as hybrid. Mating or crossing of two different species is called as hybridization, and the product formed is called as hybrid. Hybridization, the process of the mating or the crossing of two different species and the product form or the offspring form, that is called as hybrid. And that hybrid bears the characteristics of both of these species, or we can say that of the both of the parents. So we can say that jab hybrid bana to uske paas mein uske dono parents ke kuch characters aaye. He was having the characters of both these parents, but some of the characters are useful and some of the characters are not useful. For example, when we talk about the hybridization of the horse and the donkey, so the offspring is the mule. It is sterile, sexually sterile. It is of not use because mule cannot reproduce its own or mule cannot mate with the another mule because they are sterile. So there is no use of forming of that mule, and this is this type of hybridization is called as hybrid inviability. So some of the hybrid properties are useful and some of the hybrid properties are not useful. Here we will discuss the some examples relevant to hybridization. The first example relevant to hybridization that we are going to take is of Raphaena brassica. Raphaena brassica, this is one hybrid species. This is one hybrid species which is formed by the crossing of Raphaena sativus and Brassica oleracea. Raphaena brassica is one hybrid species which is formed by the crossing of Raphaena sativus and the Brassica oleracea. Raphaena sativus is reddish and Brassica oleracea is cabbage. By the hybridization of the reddish and the cabbage, the new species or the new hybrid species that was formed was Raphaena brassica. So this Raphaena sativus and oleracea, they were having in diploid condition 18 chromosomes, and when for crossing they were producing their gametes. So we know that the gametes are in the haploid condition. So here in the Raphaena sativus they were having the diploid condition. In the diploid condition they were having 18 chromosomes, and in the haploid condition when they are going to form the gamete or when the gametes were released, at that time they were having the 9 chromosomes. Here also the same, when they are going to fuse or when they are going to cross, the gametes released and they were having the 9 chromosomes. So when they cross with each other, they formed n equals to 18 or 2n equals to 18. When they cross each other, they formed one species which was 2n equals to 18, and this is the diploid condition. But this is not Raphaena brassica. Then they increase the chromosome number, or we can say that they double the chromosome number by treating with chemical. They treated this diploid species with some chemical for doubling the chromosome number. So, when they doubled the chromosome number, what they got? That here they were getting the 9 chromosomes from the Raphanus Raphanus sativus, and they were getting 9 chromosomes from the Brassica. But when they doubled the chromosome by treating them with the chemical, they were getting 9 plus 9, 2 combinations or double chromosomes from the Raphanus, and they were getting 18 chromosomes from the Brassica. Due to this, 9 plus 9 or 18 plus 18 equals to 36. Here we have been taking, or we can suppose that we are taking the 2N chromosomes from the Raphanus and 2N conditions of the chromosomes from the Brassica. So 2N equals to 4N. So Raphanus Brassica is the triploid condition, or we tetraploid condition. Raphanus Brassica is the tetraploid species, that it is having the chromosome number of 4, chromosome number in 4N situation. 4N equals to 36. Here radish and cabbage, that is Raphanus sativus and Brassica oleracea, they were having originally in the diploid condition, they were having 18 chromosomes, and when they used to cross, or they when came over for the crossing, so they produced gametes, and we know that gametes are haploid cells. So haploid cells hone ke karan they were having n equals to 9. So n equals to 9 situation jab cross hua, so they formed one species with diploid condition 2n equals to 18. But this was not the Raphanus Brassica what we get. So they treated this species with some chemical, and they increased or they doubled the chromosome number. So when they doubled the chromosome number, what we get, or what we were taking, 2N species or the 2N condition from the Raphanus and 2N condition from the cabbage. So 2N equals to 4N, and we got the Raphanus Brassica as tetraploid condition. So Raphanus Brassica is a tetraploid species. 4N equals to 36. The next example in the instant speciation, or in the case of hybridization that we are going to study it of, is of the Triticum aestivum, which is a hexaploid species. Now we will see that how the hexaploid species is being formed.